All right, what we're using is just an old, this is actually a ketchup container. Because we go through a lot of ketchup. All right, since it's Christmas time, we'll put in some snowmen. All right, once this is done, I'm just gonna bring you over to the other one. So once this is done, I'll just pick it up and hurry up and hopefully pour it into that other one. Look how pretty that blue and purple is. All right, I think we're about ready to pour. All right, so that's about as good as I can get for right now. Get back. Ah, come on. So I did preheat it with the torch. As best as I could. This should have been way further down so I could get a better pour, but you can see it kind of filled all that up from best I can tell. Did kind of splatter it a little bit, but that's all right. Now I'll just clean this a little bit up and we can reburn that. Okay, let's go ahead and take this off and see how well that works. That worked better than I thought. This isn't that big a deal. Like, whenever I put a pipe in there, it's going to mesh back to the actual metal. The lead's not going to do anything, but actually, it did pretty good. All right. So let me get this one set up. Yeah, go do that one. Purple. Yeah, I know you didn't get to see too much. That's where we're at. Had a nice little moat in the back where it came out. Oopsie. Alright, well, I'll come in and clean out the rest of this. Again, this is lead, so super easy to clean that out. I could even clean it out with a razor blade if I wanted to. Give me a minute and we'll finish that up. put the thrust bearing in and clean up everything else and go from there. All right, so I got a 3/4 inch drill bit. I don't know. I don't think you'll be able to see. But anyways, we're just going to try to clean this out best we can. I don't know how well you'll see it, but we got it all out. All right, let's go put this thing back together. It is quite a bit heavier. Okay, so I need to go ahead and kind of start reassembling this. So we're just going to put this in here. And this didn't have a washer on there, so let me go find a washer real quick to put on there. All right. And this was not tight on here at all whenever I got it. Just fit through there. Got that mounted on there. Okay, let's put that thrust bearing on. Okay, so I bought 10 of these. Maybe 5, 10? I guess 10 of these. And I'll put a link in the description, but basically you have this big washer here. And this washer here. You have your needle bearings and then another one on top, and they sandwich in together. And so obviously with this type of bearing, most bearings are kind of on the top, like but anyway, so the load on this is front and back. You can put a tremendous amount of force on this and you'll be just fine. So that way, whenever we crank this in there and that Acme screw or that screw is getting drawn in there, so whenever it gets pushed up in there, it's sandwiched in there. So as much force as you take to push it down, it's going to take that much force to release the pressure and loosen it up. Once it's loose, obviously it comes right out. But with this should allow us to put as much force as we want in, and then whenever we release it, doesn't matter because it's rolling on that bearing and it shouldn't have any kind of friction or anything like that. So put these two. So we're gonna put this little sandwich on here. A tight fit, but it's kind of what we want as well. So again, with this, all the pressure pushing down is going to be able to glide on that thrust bearing there. Okay. Just like that. All right, camera shut off. So this is what we're left with. So I think put down like that. We'll put the flat bearing or the flat washer. This can okay. We need to get get this so we can slip it in there. So clearly I'm going to have to fight this for a while, so I'll get back with you. So I should have kept filming it, because as soon as you turned you off, I basically got it. So, let's say this is the clip. I just grabbed it by the tip of it, and then pushed it down, pushed that spring down, and pushed in, and it went right in. Alright. Still got some good return spring pressure. Oh yeah. Oh yeah. That's way easier. Hope you can see how much pressure I'm putting on. Okay. So still a little bit of pressure, but not near as bad. Cool. Now, if I wanted, I could have painted this all up and all that, but I'm just gonna use it again. I'm just gonna beat it up again. It's gonna get chipped and banged on and all that stuff. I do need to do a new stand. I don't like this one at all. One, it's a little bit too high, and then obviously the other is it's pretty wobbly. So look for the link in the description for the thrust bearings if you want to do that. I think it makes a really good, easy modification you can do to one of these vices. And if I'm not mistaken, the really expensive, you know, $600 vices and all that, I'm pretty sure they all have the thrust bearings as well. So there's that. We filled these jaws up and the base part with some lead. So hopefully that'll give us a little bit more rigidity. That'll fill those cavities in there and maybe make it stronger. I don't know if it will or not, but seems about right to me. We added some weight to it, took out the voids that's in there, so hopefully that'll make it stronger as well. But yeah, all in all, pretty good. Last thing I need to do is true the vice jaw up. I don't know how well you can see that or not, but this side closes a little bit more than this side. So I guess that'll be next on this, is truing up these jaws. So you saw that I took these jaws out, and the reason why I did that is because I want to face these. So if I ever replace these jaws with aluminum ones, or if these just get tore up and I need to replace them, these jaws are true to themselves, not the jaw teeth, I guess is the best way to say that. Otherwise, I could have just stuck this in there and go at it until these were even. But again, if I did that, it would have got rid of what teeth I have on here. I don't like these teeth super sharp anyways, just because it bites too much and puts too much of an impression on whatever I'm working on. But I took these off to make these, to make the jaws actually line up better. Now on this file, on the teeth, you can see the serrated teeth on this. And then on this side, it's smooth. So I had to do this side, flip it over, do that side. And I got it in there pretty good. So if you look, those match up. They pretty much hit at the exact same time, which is what I want. Otherwise, it was clamping too much on this side, not enough on this side. So I couldn't use this full 5 inches or whatever. So if I had something really long in there, it was really only biting on one side. And I wasn't getting the full force throughout this full 5 inches. So that's why it was important. That's kind of the main reason why I came out here, was to fix that. And then we went in, we put the thrust bearing in there and filled up the cavity with lead. So anyways, let me know what you think. Y'all comment, rate. Look in the description below. That is going to be the affiliate link. Again, it doesn't cost you anything to use that link, but some of those sales do come back, and it's like fractions. And to be honest, I might make $8 or $20 a month or something like that on that. So it's not much, but it is something. It doesn't cost you anything extra. Yeah, I appreciate it. All right, guys, let me know what you think. We'll talk to you later. Thanks for watching. See ya.